I'm John Giesman. I'm an attorney for the Alliance for Nuclear Responsibility. From 1979 to 1983, the former executive director of the California Energy Commission, and from 2002 to 2008, a member of the California Energy Commission. In both of those capacities, I was responsible for the siting of new power plants. And frankly, this three-minute cap call is not a process well designed to gather thoughtful comments on how to scope an EPA. Under CEQA, we would take as much time as required to allow everybody in the audience to say whatever it was they wanted to say. I think the NRC would have to hold the same standard. I encourage each and every one of you to do the same. My verbal comments focus on joint rupture scenarios for the earthquake fault around Diablo Canyon. And this is a particular sore point with the NRC staff. The NRC staff has been criticized for a long time as to the diligence of their seismic assessment of this plant. But there has never been perhaps a more shameful episode than its research information letter 12-09 issued in the fall of 2009, which discounted the possibility of a joint rupture between the Hosby fault and the shoreline. The Alliance for Nuclear Responsibility turned over documents to the Public Utilities Commission of California last year, showing that within 5 months of the NRC staff having been taken in, PG&E acknowledged that it would assess a joint rupture scenario between the Hosbury and the shoreline fault. It did not share that information with the NRC staff for another 17 months. Lastly, the Alliance received documents, which it will turn over to the Public Utilities Commission this fall, of joint rupture analyses PG&E has performed but excluded from the report that it rushed into your hands last September before it could be reviewed by the state's independent peer review panel. That analysis was of the Hosby fault linked up to faults all the way up to the Mendocino Triple Junction, the Hosby fault linked to the shoreline fault, the Hosby fault linked to the Los Osos fault, and the Hosby fault linked to the San Luis Bay fault. Those are deterministic analyses, and I strongly implore the NRC staff to include that within its NEPA assessment. PG&E is the only NRC licensee in the history of the commercial nuclear power plant to ever be indicted by the United States Department of Justice for corrupting a federal investigation. In the words of that famous California seismologist, Ronald Reagan, trust but verify. The NRC staff has shown itself enthusiastically trusting of PG&E. It's time that you start to verify.
Every day, Diablo Canyon takes in 2.5 billion gallons of seawater and discharges that seawater back into the ocean 20 degrees hotter. So much for nuclear power as a solution for global warming. It has been estimated by biologists that more than 1.5 billion fish die annually in early life stages as a result of the antiquated cooling system at Diablo Canyon. While the State Water Resource Control Board may be considered creating an interim mitigation fee, this fee won't do anything to address the loss of aquatic life or the real cost of allowing this much ocean warming to go unchecked. Governor Brown has set very serious goals for the reduction of climate change in the near future. We need to do everything we can to meet those goals. Although it's been argued that nuclear power is clean and will help meet climate change goals, because nuclear power plants like Diablo that are at risk of closing can't compete with cheaper natural gas and renewables, this week the EPA announced states will no longer be able to meet their clean energy goals by extending the licenses of these nuclear power plants. At a time when the world's oceans are reeling from the effects of overfishing and ocean acidification threatens the global ocean's ability to produce the green life that supports all life on Earth, including human life, it is unconscionable that this wasteful and unnecessary technology be allowed to continue its assault on the Pacific Ocean and to slow our passage to a safe and sustainable energy future. Shut down the Yellow Canyon today. Jackson Bradley.
David Crosby is here to always represent also Honor Ray Jackson Barber Grand National, who submitted statements for the shutdown of the Yellow Canyon nuclear plant. We want the commission to recognize that we are in favor of a full employment for all the operators at Diablo Canyon. It will be shutting down. We hope that the operators at Diablo will stay on for the decommissioning process because they know the plant better than anybody. We also understand that when Diablo is shut, there will be many, many thousands of jobs in the renewable energy industry that will pick up that will create more jobs, more wealth, and certainly be better for the environment than what Diablo Canyon is. We understand that since Diablo has come online, a dozen earthquake faults have been found within the proximity of the reactors. That needs to be discussed. We want to know what happened to Dr. Michael Peck, who was the president safety inspector, who did report on the seismic dangers of Diablo Canyon, so that they cannot withstand the earthquakes there. We want Dr. Peck back at Diablo Canyon and his report dealt with properly. We also understand that there is embrittlement at these reactors, and there are water issues that the state of California needs to take up. The state of California can shut Diablo Canyon. It is not in compliance with the law on water quality standards in many different ways, and it's up to us as Californians to get the state to shut this reactor as soon as possible. We also want the evacuation plans looked at. Once again, we want to know about the crack and the dry casks at where there has been improper loading of spent fuel. And above all, we want to make it clear that Diablo Canyon will shut. We need it shut before the next earthquake. We want the people at the plant to continue to be there for the decommissioning process, and we look forward to the transition to renewable energy, to Solartopia, which is happening right now. And that's where the jobs are, that's where the economy is, that's where the future of this planet is. Thank you very much. We all know Diablo can be shut. The question is whether it's been shut before the earthquake destroys it and us. We had Dr. Peck at the plant, one of the leading experts in the entire Nuclear Regulatory Commission, who issued a report saying the reactors could not withstand a likely earthquake deliverable by the dozen faults there. If you get to relicensing, this has to be dealt with. Dr. Peck has to be brought back to Diablo Canyon out of exile. It's so rare that we get a candid report from inside the commission, and you need to look, and the entire commission needs to look much more closely at what Dr. Peck says about the dozen earthquake faults that have been found around Diablo. I was arrested at Diablo in 1984, where we were still arguing about the Hosby fault, and now there are a dozen there. I should also point out, you need to look at the fact that Diablo is 45 miles from the San Andreas Fault, which is half as far as Fukushima was from the earthquake that destroyed it. You also need to look now at the tsunami issue. It's been generally poo-pooed, but the reality is that there are intake pipes at sea level and even below at Diablo Canyon that would be impacted by a tsunami, even if the reactors themselves are 85 feet in the air. That has to be looked at very closely. We are already having dry cast cracking in terms of the waste storage. There's embrittlement, there are evacuation issues. There are also health impacts. Since you will be looking at this, I co-authored a book called Killing Our Own in 1982. I interviewed people in central Pennsylvania after the Three Mile Island accident. It was the worst week of my life. I guarantee you people were killed at Three Mile Island. This needs to be revisited, and we also see a million person death toll documented at Chernobyl, and God knows what's going to happen at Fukushima. 300 tons of radioactive water are still pouring into the ocean there. I was in Japan when Fukushima was being opened. We were assured that, of course, nothing like an earthquake or tsunami could happen there that would destroy it. Finally, on the jobs impact, This, I'm not sure if you can look at the economic impacts in this particular proceeding, but everyone here who opposes Diablo should understand that jobs are a real issue. We want a federal jobs program for all the people who are working at the reactors. We want them kept on for the decommissioning process, and we want them placed in the industry that does have a future in this country, which is renewable energy. And when you look at relicensing anything like this, you need to look at the economic and ecological impacts of the transition from an old decrepit nuclear power plant like Diablo into the world of solar panels, wind power, and all the stuff that actually does work and will create an environment in the future where our children and grandchildren can survive. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you.
We know that Diablo is just 45 miles from the San Andreas Fault. The quake that destroyed Fukushima was twice that distance from the reactors there. Given our short time here, we want to urge you to finally and truly act as independent regulators. We ask you to put the health and safety of the public first, ahead of the short-term needs of PG&E, ahead of the agenda of the nuclear power industry. For the safety of California, we ask you to shut the album up.
I'm Jill Zamek with San Francisco Mothers for Peace, and I live in Rio Grande. The topic I'd like the NRC to look at is human performance deficiencies. There are an unacceptable number of human performance deficiencies at the Diablo Canyon facility, particularly involving identification and resolution of problems. There were 29 violations documented by the NRC in 2014, and overwhelmingly, the root cause of these violations pointed to human performance deficiencies. These violations involved fire protection, inoperable emergency diesel generators, occupational radiation safety, poor maintenance planning on safety-related equipment, failure to follow procedures, problems with design control, and multiple instances of failure to identify and evaluate system interactions regarding seismically induced systems. 11 of the violations involve security or materials control. One finding identified a violation dating back to the original construction building process from 1974. Three of the violations involve the corrective action program, identifying and resolving problems. There is an enormous backlog of problems involving operable but long-standing degraded conditions of the plant. Some problems were simply not identified in a timely manner, some disregarded and not put in the corrective action program, and others inappropriately delayed. As of August 2014, there were 29 documented degraded conditions affecting safety-related equipment, the oldest dating from June 2008. The median age of the problems was 1,176 days post-identification. In the words of the NRC from the inspection report, there exists, quote, a large number of long-standing degraded or non-conforming conditions, some of which had not been appropriately addressed by compensatory measures or interim corrective actions. A more recent blunder was revealed in May of this year. 19 of its 34 dry casks used to store spent fuel were loaded to the manufacturer's technical specifications, particularly as they relate to the proper ratio of older and newer spent fuel. The root cause was determined to be reactor engineering personnel misinterpreting the technical specifications. At the June 24th, 2015 NRC PG&E 2014 performance assessment, San Luis Obispo, Ed Halpin referred to these performance flaws as gaps in excellence. The numerous documented gaps demonstrate the enormous risk we face. The plant should not only be denied relicensing, it should cease to operate now.
Spring of 2011, PG&E and the NRC proved us right, and the process was delayed. PG&E is well aware that California is far from approving 20 more years of operation. In March of 2010, the California Coastal Commission made it clear to PG&E that, quote, the six-month period review under the Coastal Zone Management Act has not commenced and will not commence until we receive the missing necessary data and information. As of last Monday, the Coastal Commission has not received that information. PG&E told this community in 2010 that the reason they had filed a license renewal request early was because the PUC needed the utility to make a decision and then submit an application. Supposedly, the PUC was concerned that if the license was not granted, they would need at least 10 years to replace the outlet. Yet on March 27, 2015, CPUC President Picker, quote, reiterated that PG&E's study of a potential license extension for Diablo Canyon should include 18 criteria. Although the 3 minutes allowed doesn't allow me to read them, as of today, those 18 criteria have not been met. PG&E has not completed its seismic studies. On January 9th of this year, Dr. Norman Abrahamson, PG&E's chief technical integrator for the Shaft Report, nonchalantly suggested to the California's independent peer review panel that ground motion data deficiencies will be addressed in PG&E's 2025 update. On a non-seismic note, alternatives to PG&E's devastating cooling process and permanent wave storage of radioactive waste are unresolved issues. This past Sunday, the local paper quoted PG&E spokesperson as saying PG&E has not made a decision yet. So why are you here? The cost of ignoring our pressing comments has not been borne by the NRC. Just because the NRC's budget has been cut and the nuclear renaissance has become an expensive nuclear fizzle, there is no reason to restart an expensive, premature license renewal process. How are we supposed to provide reasonable input to a process that has no meaning until California determines whether or not we want to invest in continued operation of aging nuclear power plants? Go home, NRC. Wait for PG&E to get seismic, cooling, and waste ducks in a row, and quit wasting great care.
Humans make mistakes. I've made money. People have.
everybody had human error, pilot error, and put a plant into a meltdown or a blow-up. Can happen. Mother Nature can kick our ass. There's never been a building built that a big enough earthquake can't knock down. That's for sure. Thirdly, somebody can dive an airplane full of explosives into a pool of, quote, spent, unquote, rods. Any of those things can happen. You may have opinions about whether they're likely or not, but they can happen. Here's what I want to talk about. If one of those things does happen, and an earthquake will happen, it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. Now, I've sailed this whole coast my whole life. If you have loss of containment or meltdown, the wind goes from here right down the coast. I've sailed it, you know what that is. Down for thousands of years. 12 to 15 every afternoon, 12 to 15 miles. Let's be conservative and say 10 miles an hour. Okay, Santa Barbara, Ventura, Oxnard, Los Angeles, Orange County. Let's again be conservative. Say it's only 10 million people. It's more. Okay? How many people do you think you can get out of Los Angeles in 18 hours? Is it 10 miles an hour? That's how long it would take. All of them? Half? A quarter? 10%? 4%? Human lungs. Plants are dangerous. They're terribly dangerous. Flying a plane is dangerous. I know, by the way. Driving your car is dangerous. But it's only dangerous to you or the people on the plane. When there's millions of people downwind, it's an unacceptable risk. An earthquake can and will eventually destroy this planet. Do you, as human beings, parents, brothers, sisters, want it on your conscience? I know some of you feel your jobs are at stake. I know some of you feel winning the arguments at stake. But do you want it on your conscience? If it goes the way I'm saying, do you want it? You want to know that 1.5 million people died? Because you wouldn't take a stand? Plant's dangerous. It's all, they built it backwards. That's funny. They built it on a fault. That's not.
Hi, I'm Marty Magda from Laguna Beach, a concerned citizen. I've been following the nuclear issue since I would have been killed when Fukushima took place because I was in Palau, and as that tidal wave went toward Oregon, had come my way, I would have died. So I came instead to find out how safe nuclear was in California. I want to say to all of you here, from the bottom of my heart, who believe in nuclear, that all of us who want to arrest global change of climate are with you. We want very much to recognize global warming is a terrible issue. Rising tides, tsunamis, the types of horrible storms that we're about to face, the challenges in our future are huge. What I'm here to ask with my research, Diablo is 8% of California's energy. If we turned off our lights from midnight on, California can save that now. It would be hard on our utilities because they wouldn't get the money that they need. As the NRC goes after this environmental look again at Diablo, it must take into account, which we didn't do in San Onofre. Any new, the environmental impact report said there was no problem with San Onofre anywhere. And we must look at the Cascadia Fault. We must look at the San Andreas Fault as we understand it today, not in the 60s. We have to understand rising tides because the area on the ocean is going to move to going underwater. Right now there's storage fuel in Florida that is not transportable, and that is projected to have a whole state going underwater. Believe me, I understand global warming as a huge issue. What we have is a nuclear industry that has not looked at the back end of waste. And we must have storage and transportation and it must be standardized. We can't have every energy company in the country changing how their canisters are cast, their transport system. I ask the Nuclear Regulatory Commission to make it be standardized, to work with any bill in the country so that there is a dry transfer storage system right now built at Diablo, right now built in San Onofre, so that we have a way to get the dry casks out of there, because interim storage for 100 years or 340 years, which is now allowed by the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, will not work in California. I don't care what you think about nuclear in the rest of the country, but California is in the fire zone of earthquake. We cannot leave our fuel here for 100 years in canisters that right now, I can tell you, Holtec already let us know on July 23rd that their canisters that are here at Diablo are inferior. I'm sorry I'm cut off now, but you need to look into that. They are only alloy 304 instead of 316L, which we have at San Onofre, which still won't last for 30 years.
Thank you. Tom Campbell. I'm a board member of Musicians United for Safe Energy and a founding member. I'm also executive director of the Guacamole Fund. Both of these are nonprofit organizations that work in energy education. In regards to the last speaker spoke about evacuation, this is a billboard that we put up back in the early 80s, 25 of them around town. As there's no commissioners here to see, I'll read it to you. It says, "Warning, Diablo Canyon evacuation zone." I have been asked by Graham Nash, the musician and activist who is also a board member of Musicians United for Safe Energy, to read the following statement. "My friends Jackson Brown, Bonnie Raitt, James Taylor, Linda Ronstadt, David Crosby, Stephen Stills, and I started to oppose nuclear power by supporting Proposition 15, the Nuclear Safeguards Initiative, back in 1976. There were six plants under construction that would have been permitted by that initiative. The initiative would stop those six plants from being constructed. There were two in operation at that time, Humboldt Reactor up in Northern California and San Onofre number one down by Camp Pendleton. Both of them are gone now, shut down for certain reasons. Of the six I mentioned completed, four have been shut down for financial and safety reasons. Only the two at Diablo Canyon remain, and as everyone knows, they were both built in active, dangerous seismic zones. We have participated many times, raising funds, disseminating information, and supporting global grassroots and national organizations to help empower people to act, and will continue to do so in the future. My friends and I sincerely believe that the Diablo Canyon nuclear power plant is an accident waiting to happen. Please, if just for the sake of our children and our grandchildren, we must try our best to see that the dreadful, expensive accidents like Three Mile Island, Chernobyl, and Fukushima will not happen here. Thank you."
I'm Jill Zamek with Mothers for Peace. I live in Rio Grande. I would like to first preface my comments with the acknowledgement that the NRC is looking for new information here today, issues to look at specifically for Diablo Canyon, and there are numerous such issues. But the two most pressing, which are not new, are one, this plant has been absurdly sited in an area riddled with active earthquake faults, and two, we still don't know how to protect the byproduct known as high-level radioactive waste, which remains toxic for hundreds of thousands of years. You might label these generic issues, but they are the primary concerns of the residents in this community. An additional issue is that Pacific Gas and Electric Company has lost its credibility. The Japanese parliament concluded that collusion between regulator, industry, and government officials was the root cause of the ongoing Fukushima nuclear catastrophe. Frighteningly, the Diablo Canyon plant is operated by PG&E,
a company under multiple federal indictments for safety violations in the recent fatal explosion of its San Bruno, California gas pipeline. It is also embroiled in an evolving scandal about illegal back-channel communications with the state's Public Utilities Commission. We cannot trust this company to maintain public safety as their highest priority. We do not want Fukushima in California. This is a site-specific issue relating only to the owner of the Diablo Canyon nuclear facility. A further topic is the threat of tsunami. I understand that PG&E and the NRC feel protected from the tsunami threat because of the 85-foot cliff and the placement of the snorkels, but that secure feeling is not shared by all. In a report which the NRC held private for 11 years, a preliminary numerical study of the hazard for local landslide tsunami scenarios at the Diablo Canyon site in Central California, published November 22, 2003, the investigator Dr. R.T. Sewell concluded that, quote, the existing tsunami design bases and perceptions of tsunami risk for the Diablo Canyon site no longer reflect modern scientific understanding and methods. There is compelling evidence to suggest that the tsunami threat may be considerably more significant than held in these existing bases and perceptions. And correspondingly, such existing bases and perceptions no longer appear adequate, end quote. Dr. Sewell provided six recommendations in his concluding comments of his report, one of them being that the licensee of the Diablo Canyon site, quote, justify and or reevaluate the tsunami design bases and perform a state-of-the-art assessment of tsunami hazard and risk, including the plan and its system, within the umbrella of its existing long-term seismic program, end quote. I'm combining the effects of tsunami tides, storm surge, and winds, all of Sewell's 13 postulated scenarios of the investigation produced waves that go beyond Diablo Canyon's design basis. In fact, all 13 scenarios produce wave heights that could impact the seawater intake. This issue is certainly a site-specific environmental concern, allowed Fukushima to be our warning.